We identified that there was a huge hole in sustainable ag groups around our district. With the help of the EPNRM and the local farmers, we became a group. The group's got 25 active members, probably farm over 300,000 plus acres. So it's a huge area of cropping and sheep country.
This area in particular was sort of missing that service for the younger generation of farmers from the 20 to 40 years old, which I think that we can all get some good ideas off each other.
Get as many different local seeding rigs together to put them in a paddock to test out their own seeding systems, all in the same paddock under the same conditions, same timing, just with a uniform seeding and fertiliser rate, and see how they compare.
Seeing what other people's air seeders work like, so side by side it's a pretty good representation of what machines do what in the same conditions.
It's very simple. The graph comes up, it tells you the moisture at 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, down to a metre deep, the available soil moisture. And it also gives you a summed graph of the total moisture available in the profile. As opposed to digging a hole to see where the moisture is, now I can look at a computer and a graph and it tells me what's there. But I suppose over time we'll get a little bit better grasp of how to really interpret that data. Oh, as simple as I just hit the app button, log in, and within, depending on my internet speed, I'll have the information in front of me in 30 seconds.
Met lots of girls that I had nothing to do with, so just for that fact of the networking part of it is fantastic. We're all kind of in it together. The women stay home with kids and look after the house, and now we're kind of getting more into the paddocks, and I guess we're helping out the boys a lot more and taking on a little bit more of the workload, the stress as well, because you can share it between husband and wife. A group of women all getting together and actually learning about what's kind of a boys' society. It's fun and it's exciting.
She comes home and tells me what she's learnt, and I have to make out I know most of it, or we have a discussion about what she's done for the day. I think it's very beneficial.
I think as a group, everybody is probably more aware of other issues that we probably didn't rate as highly important. That I think now everybody's seeing that there's room to really push the production limits a lot higher for our area, especially by taking an interest in these other aspects that the group have identified. A lot of knowledge in our group, there's a lot of well-educated farmers around here that are pretty young and are really willing to share their information from the science side of it, as well as everybody's got their own anecdotal evidence of what they do on their own farms, and by putting that together, everybody's benefiting from that.
Having this group established, everyone sort of knows each other, and there's no ill feeling or anything amongst anyone. So when someone puts a question or a query up on Twitter, it's amazing the amount of responses you'll get from blokes involved in this group, and you get quite a lot of free information and good information.
I come along to these things when the opportunity arises, just to kind of get more knowledge about farming. I guess not coming from a farming background, I don't know a lot at all. It's a huge learning curve. We're only kind of reaching the surface of most things.
The more things we can do as a group, we could travel around as a group and have a look at what different areas are doing and showcase what we're doing to other groups.
Farming's not a competition. It's about learning from each other, and what better way of doing it than getting out together and seeing what each other's doing. And makes you aim for better, like you can see that there's potential in what you're doing. There's a lot of young farmers around that I think are going to benefit greatly going forward.